WNBA on 2K Sports. And in our matchup tonight, we'll see the Seattle Storm going up against the Phoenix Mercury. Courtside with Tim Schwartz and Brian Benefitemi, I'm Blake Suniga, and we've got a fun one. And so off the tip is Seattle. Here's Bird, guarded closely, pass to Russell. Bird, shot clock at 5. The floater, not gonna go that time. Brittany Griner with a defensive effort. Rossi with it. Pass to Breland. Here's Diggins-Smith, guarded by Bird. And Skylar Diggins-Smith, good from deep.
A part of Diggins-Smith's game that she continues to work on, but a fiery competitor like her never sets limits on what they can and can't do.
Knocked loose. Now here's Bird, Breland defending. To the paint. And Stewart gets it to go.
An intelligent scorer like Stewart knows that points can come from anywhere. That's just beautiful teamwork.
Now here is Breland. She's off on that one.
Well, this is why you need good defenders inside contesting shots.
Yeah, making every shot a tough shot, even in tight.
Outside Stewart. Jessica Breland with some nice moves.
If she can get to the rim, she'll usually turn it into points, but the defense stood tall there.
Now here's Diggins-Smith, guarded by Bird. A nice shot by Diggins-Smith.
Brings so much intensity to the court. Diggins-Smith energizes her entire team with plays like that.
Pass to Howard. To Bird. Now here's Howard over Breland. That one a little long.
Well, she rushed that one. He was out of position, but she couldn't make him pay.
And she makes the first. And so she makes both from the line. Seattle trailing here. Some tough offensive sets, and they really want to turn it around.
They got to lock in and need a basket just to regain some momentum.
Howard, that's good.
Getting easy buckets for teammates. That's what Sue Bird does, and she's been doing it for a long time.
Now here's Diggins-Smith, guarded by Bird. Diggins-Smith's shot is off. Stolen by Jessica Breland. Yep, counted. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Pass to Russell. Up top, Bird. Down low, Howard. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Such a high IQ. Bird just figures out defenses. She dissects them one pass at a time.
Rossi outside. Breland, pass to Diggins-Smith. 4 on the shot clock. And down it goes. 2 points.
One of the most coachable players in the league. Diggins-Smith's curiosity leads to her constant improvement.
Now here is Lloyd. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Here's Howard. Jessica Breland comes up with the rebound. Phoenix leading. Pass to to Diggins Smith. Here's DeRossi. Here's the teardrop.
Phenomenal defense from Stewart on that play. It's no surprise she's regarded as one of the best shot blockers in the league.
And here's Howard. Russell. Right side Stewart. Now here's Bird. Side Lloyd. This one for three. No good. And it's Phoenix the other way. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Natasha Howard. That's foul number two for her.
That's her second foul of the first quarter. You might want to sit her down for a while to avoid the third foul.
Pass to Taurasi. Hartley outside. The three is up. Russell pulls it in. And here is Howard. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
The body control on her is tremendous. Lloyd is not easily taken off her game. Impressive make.
Tipped away. Jordan Canada with the steal. Howard. She hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
You like to see it. She's been working really hard to get good looks, and it's paying off here early.
Pass to Coffey. Breland outside. Rhea Hartley, the open look. That one rolling around and rims out. Here's Lloyd. Soft touch off the glass.
Timeout.
The handles on Lloyd are nasty, and she just drives it going straight to the hoop.
Timeout called the Mercury.
Oh, they're pretty disappointed, this coaching staff, and rightfully so. Just they're giving up a big run right now. Got to figure out a way to stop it.
Yeah, they haven't really looked good at all here lately. Something's got to change for them. Let's see what the coaching staff has up their sleeve.
Trail. Here's Walker Kimbrough. And no good. Alicia Clark with the defensive effort.
Well, you have to like their work in the boards here in the first.
Yeah, coming out of the gates with great energy. Kind of like they got shot out of a cannon. They're really setting the tone.
Oh,
Russell misses. And it's Bria Hartley penetrating. Second shot opportunity. Rebound by Brianna Stewart.
Yeah, I mean, she has been way off the mark this quarter. It is getting rough.
Pass to Clark. Stewart. He's guarded by Hartley. Clock at six. Knocks it loose. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Guarded by Canada. Here's Coffey. Reiner. 6 to shoot. That one wide left.
Not sure what the D was doing there. She's not the player to give open looks to, but they got away with it that time.
Good on the bucket.
Transitioning into pretty much whatever role the team needs. It's Clark's ability to adapt that really impresses me.
Here's Coffey. To stop the run. Reiner's shot is good.
That's the area they want to work the ball into, and it takes passing like that to do it.
Here's Canada, and Brittany Griner with the block.
Another block by Griner. Normally, she leads the league in blocks.
Pass to Turner. Over to the left wing. Here's Walker Kimbrough. That one's in. Her first basket of the game. She is 1 for 2.
Yeah, good job working it down low and getting the high percentage look.
And here's Clark. Now here's Russell. Outside Canada. Doesn't go for her.
Excellent interior D right there to force the miss.
Yeah, and unlike you, Tim, her defensive ability is a huge factor. No doubt about it.
Now here is Canada. Wyatt so far offensively searching for her first points of the game. Whitcomb misses. Phoenix in the lead. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Back to Hartley. Griner, guarded by Canada. Count it.
In the paint, Griner simply unstoppable. She's so tall at 6'9", but she also has lovely touch.
And that does it for the first quarter. It's the Mercury, up 5. And the second quarter is on the way when we return. Think about the Mercury here in this one.
Not much room to operate on this one. A very tough D through one.
You know, they haven't given up a lot of easy chances at all.
Now Hartley. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. And here's Griner.
Whitcomb defending.
To the middle. The second effort. It's outside, and it's good for 2.
Yeah, coaches fall in love with Clark's demeanor because she means business when she's on the court.
Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Here's Turner. She's covered by Clark. Shot clock at 6. The putback. It's good on the putback.
They're beginning to just fall apart defensively, especially on the interior.
Yeah, they're crumbling like a cookie right now, and that's 4 straight field goals they've allowed from within touching distance of the rim.
From 11 feet away, good for the basket, starting off 1 for 1 with that shot. Phoenix with the ball. 3-point lead. Here's Walker Kimbrough. She's covered by Clark. Hartley, and the 3 off target.
You know, you watch her and you see her mechanics are totally out of whack right now. She's lost all feel for her shot.
Yeah, and it's not hard to tell. You know, just look at her numbers right now. Nothing is going down for her.
And it's Turner missing. And here are the Storm now. They've only given up 2 points this quarter. Here's Whitcomb, and she drops in the layup off glass.
Ran her defender straight into that screen to open up the lane to the hoop.
Pass to Griner. Walker Kimbrough. Here's Turner. Here's Walker Kimbrough, guarded by Canada. Goes up on the stripe, and good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. Seattle trailing here. Time called here. The Storm decide to talk it over. Nice game. Great performance by Brittany Griner.
She has absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit the damage she's doing inside.
Second quarter play with almost 3 minutes gone.
Stolen by Diggins-Smith.
And a fast break now for the Mercury. And the shot is good.
A nice 1-2 punch there, guys. Great defensive play, great bucket in transition.
That's how to play aggressive, attacking basketball.
And that's matching your defense with your offense.
Pass to Bird. Got a piece of it. Here's Turner, guarded by Bird. Some solid defense from Sue Bird.
Well, you love the tough D, especially inside.
And that's exactly what she gives you, Tim. Constantly making her presence felt around the rim.
Pass to Turner. Yep, that one goes.
They're finding lanes to the hoop every time down. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Or at least some fight.
And here's Howard.
From past the arc.
But they get it back. That's off. And it's her fourth miss in seven attempts. Rossi outside. Back to Breland. The basket good off the assist from Diana Taurasi.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. And I know nobody likes a traffic jam, but this defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Yeah, nobody likes a traffic jam. We can agree on that. They can't allow the offense to get those high-quality looks inside.
Pass to Griner. And she was fouled in the act of shooting. Opportunity for a three-point play.
This has been a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring from the paint.
You know, really, that's why they're on this run. You get that close to the hoop, and it's a lot easier to drop shots in.
Find the lane. Find the lane. One shot.
The late blossoming of her offense has been incredible. Griner, her scoring average improved by 5 points during season 5 of the WNBA.
Pass to Howard. Stewart inside. It's stolen by Breland. Now here's Diggins-Smith. Griner to Rossi outside. Diggins-Smith with it. Down to five on the shot clock. And good that time. Now here's Bird. And that's a foul called on Diana Taurasi. That is her first foul of the game. The Mercury making a switch here. Outside Lloyd. Six on the shot clock. The three. It's not going to go for her. And it's Phoenix the other way. Up top, Diggins-Smith. Shot from free throw range. And it's Seattle with the rebound.
Didn't see that miss coming. She's usually so good from that range.
Back to Bird. Side Lloyd. Langhorne. The shot's good on the assist by Jewel Lloyd.
Nice low post offense.
Breland outside. Pass to Coffey. Now to Rossi. Over Stewart to Rossi, and that's good.
Defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
And if they don't start showing some aggression, things are just going to get worse.
Bird with it. Shoots over Diggins-Smith. Bird no good. Outside Diggins-Smith. Pass to Taurasi. To the inside. Reiner's shot's good.
She's been one of their more reliable options today, and it's her shooting that has given them this lead.
And they've been struggling here offensively.
Bit of a dry spell for sure.
Here's Lloyd. From 13 feet, down it goes.
The sick handles of Lloyd, it works well in the two-player game. It puts defenders into a tough spot.
Diana Taurasi on the wing. There's the triple, up and in, off to an efficient start. 2 for 3 from the field.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Bird outside. Right side, Lloyd. Nice pass, led into the rack perfectly for the layup.
You know, she shot the ball well, but it hasn't been contagious.
And the Mercury call time here.
Yeah, coach wants to get everybody on the same page out there and maybe change up some things as well.
Yeah, that's probably a good timeout. You might as well talk things through.
And kind of change that game plan as well.
Phoenix. Hartley outside. Over to the wing. Turner guarded by Howard. And there's a whistle. That's going to go on Breonna Stewart. That's her first foul. Pass to Turner. Walker Kimbrough. 5 on the clock. Now Hartley. Whitcomb defending. To the paint. Coffee.
A quality shot contest will always put a smile on your coach's face. Stewart's one of the league's smartest defenders.
And you know, honestly, if you're looking for the main reason they're trailing in this game, look no further than her shooting. She's hit exactly 0% of her shots tonight.
Elbow. 2. At the line.
No good on that one. Good on the second free throw. Canada with it. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Stewart inside. Outside Canada. Clock at 6. Takes the 13-footer against Seattle.
And she should thank the D for those 2 points. Nobody really paying much attention to her there.
Now 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Reiner, guarded by Russell. Back to Hartley. And here's Griner. 13 points in this game. Here's Walker Kimbrough. That one doesn't drop. Excellent D there from Mercedes Russell. From D. And no good trying to get that one. And so that brings the first half to a close. Mercury out in front. They lead by 12. And don't go away after the break. We'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number 3.
know, Griner has been really making it happen here.
Her rebounding, particularly the offensive rebounding, was superb in the first half. She was really battling hard inside.
And that allowed them to get several shots on the same possession multiple times. I mean, her work on the offensive glass has been invaluable.
Getting back to the action now, it's been a one-team show so far, but we'll see if that changes. Pass to Coffey. A rebound by Brianna Stewart. Bird outside. Boyd with it, guarded by Diggins Smith. Foul call that time on the way up.
Consistently in the top 10 in free throws made, Lloyd knows how to bait defenders. Very high IQ.
This is her first opportunity at the line this evening.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
Really arriving on the international stage, Lloyd was part of the 2018 national team, helping the team win the world championships in Spain.
That's also good, so she hits them both. And it's the Mercury with the ball. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Pass to Griner. They get a hand on it. It's stolen by Stewart. Brianna Stewart draws the double. Lloyd from long range. Unable to get that one to go. And the Mercury going the other way now. Bucket is good.
An absolute floor general. Vision and passing are the trademarks of Diggins Smith's game.
Outside Howard. Pass to Bird. Russell, five to shoot, over Griner. Russell with the bucket.
That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
Now here's Diggins Smith. She's covered closely. With the floater, the basket good off the assist from Diana Taurasi.
Mechanically sound, even on unconventional shots. Diggins Smith does a pretty good job playing to her strength.
Shot from 12, and too long on the shot. And these guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
When everybody's involved offensively, it's in a way helping you defensively, too.
Of their last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is smash-mouth basketball.
Yeah, they're really imposing their will offensively and getting exactly the kind of looks they want.
It's stolen by Griner. Here's Coffey, guarded by Bird. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two.
What a play in attack mode and get inside.
And the defense gets their money's worth on that foul, stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
At the line for two.
And the first one drops. And she makes both free throws. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. To Stewart. Just five on the clock. And that's going to be too many steps. Gets the whistle on the travel.
He's not doing that any favors making those kind of errors.
Especially now with every possession being a critical one for them at this point.
Just the worst time for it to happen.
Now here's Diggins Smith, guarded by Bird. Out to Taurasi. Again, Phoenix, no good. away. It's stolen by Griner. The drive by Diana Taurasi. And some very quick points for them on that possession.
What a mismatch it's been in the post. I mean, where's the defensive adjustment? They're just getting eaten alive out there.
Yeah, I agree. They got to come up with something. A double team, maybe a sub. This is getting ridiculous.
Still cold from the field at the start of this third quarter. 1-4 so far.
Outside, Diggins-Smith. This is her third shot of the game. She has made 6 of her 9 attempts. Now here's Bird, guarded by Diggins-Smith. Bird gets the bucket.
Smarts go a long way, and Bird has learned how to navigate under the hoop. Even standing at 5'9", she can score inside.
Taurasi outside, pass to Diggins-Smith. It's rebounded by Seattle.
Well, got it in close, but credit the tight defense for forcing the miss.
Defense like that ups the degree of difficulty on that shot by about what? I'd say 300%?
308%, maybe.
Okay, I like that. Well, offensively speaking, it has been a tough, tough quarter for her.
Here's Howard. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
An attentive player who sees the floor well. Clark really understands how to distribute the rock.
Back to Taurasi. Pass to Diggins-Smith. The three ball. Knocks down the three ball.
Scoring the ball effectively so far. Diggins-Smith has a rare combination of skill, quickness, and playmaking ability.
Seattle calls timeout.
Her shot selection hasn't been great tonight. A lot of forced, contested shots all game. She'll be lucky if she just gets a talking to here instead of being taken out of the game.
Identity is really what makes Clark a threat to score anytime she's on the court.
And it's out of bounds. The Mercury able to retain possession here. Here's Walker Kimbrough. She's covered by Clark. Pass to Hartley. 6 to shoot. Good work defensively by Sammy Whitcomb. Howard inside. 8 points for her. Got her with the pump fake. Just couldn't finish. Trying to add a few more points to their lead.
And it's not rocket science at this point. Just stay with what you've been doing. That might be the last player in this league you want to get an offensive board. At 6'9", Griner can get the ball back up and in real quick.
Back to Canada. They recover it. Turner. Pass to Walker Kimbrough. Griner. Here's Hartley. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Here's Whitcomb. Off with the layup.
Yeah, remember that. That's not an opportunity. She fails to convert very often.
Pass to Griner. They double-team Brittany Griner. Walker Kimbrough, guarded by Howard. Here's Here's Walker Kimbrough. And took the basket. He was fouled. And she's going to the line for one more.
And this is her first trip to the line tonight.
Right, their offense is ground to a standstill.
Maybe you need to suit up, Tim. They need a spark. Left side, Howard. Just five to shoot. They need this. And it's Brittany Griner with the rebound.
A slight rebound advantage to them. One more column in their favor. It's all adding up.
Well, you look across the team stats, it's one of many areas they're winning. And they've secured a big lead.
It looks very sharp tonight.
I'm loving it.
Hornet Canada drives in. Up again. Great positioning on the putback.
A worker's mentality. Howard crashes the O-boards, looking for second chance points.
Pass to Hartley. It doesn't go for her. Good work defensively by Sammy Whitcomb.
It's been that kind of a game for her, but look, the team is still winning, so keep your head up and just try to move on and be better from this.
Now here is Canada. She's guarded by Hartley. Pass to Russell. And it's Phoenix with the rebound.
And terrific defense at the rim, got right in her path.
And you know they'll be worrying about her next time they take it inside, too. And really, that's what great defenders will do to you.
Clark outside. And the officials that's will green. Call the illegal screen here.
Well, that's number five. One more foul, and she's done.
So both teams making some changes here. And they're in complete control.
Everything they're doing, it's been working out. Wow.
Hartley, right side. Pass to Griner. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. It's on Mercedes Russell.
An elite athlete for a player of her build. Griner's willing to battle on the interior.
And she's gone 1-for-1 in the game so far at the line. And the first one falls for her. Hits both of them. Outside Canada. She got it up in time, but it couldn't fall for it. And three quarters of play in the books. This one's all but over already. It's the Mercury running away with this one. And we've got more in store for you right after this. Candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Well, this is what being on the same page looks like. Fantastic feed and a heads-up play all around.
And how can you not be a fan of a sequence like that? This is what beautiful basketball is all about.
Yeah, unselfishness, just wonderful stuff.
And thanks again for joining us. We'll see what happens in the fourth. Away. Here's Stewart. Lays it up and in off the nice reverse.
They tried to increase the degree of difficulty for Stewart. Didn't matter. She has the strength and focus to take a bump and make the basket.
A nice shot by Ryder. Now Bird. Bird.
Curry going the other way now. Here's Walker Kimbrough, defended by Stewart. Pass to Griner.
And the play stops. Whistle on what looks like an illegal screen.
Very close call there on the illegal screen.
I'd go along with it. You know, to me, it didn't really look like her feet were set.
Up top, Bird. Clark. Russell controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
What terrific hustle. She's got a nose for those rebounds.
Wow, she is ferocious when that ball goes up.
And that's what they've got her out there for, making plays like that.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix.
Looks like the coach saw some things out there that needed adjusting. And it's going to take a little time to talk it over.
Yeah, never a bad idea to use a timeout if there's something that's got you concerned.
About a minute and a half off the clock in it. Pass to Taurasi. Shot clock at 6. Shot from the top of the key. Can't get it to drop. She's made 4 and just missed her 4. Outside Canada. Outside Stewart. Releases. That one a tad offline to the right, but it drops in for her.
Yeah, good luck. If you're the player who has to guard her, it is never going to be an easy night.
Rossi outside. It's good, and with that basket, she is now 5 for 9.
One of the most daring scorers in the league. Taurasi excels at finding ways to score despite tight defense.
Pass to Canada. Inside. Stewart can't hit.
The defense is ready for her. Got a hand in her face. And made that one much tougher.
And that's something that every team needs. Rugged interior defense to just make your opponent think twice about coming down the lane.
Clark. To Canada. Shoots over Hartley.
Shot by Canada, no good.
Rossi outside. Hartley outside. And here's Griner. So the whistle blows on the shot. 2 free throws for the contact there.
We're still waiting for their first miss from the line this half.
100% since halftime? I'm not sure this lead's going away anytime soon.
At the line for 2.
The first free throw is good. Both teams will make substitutions. Makes 1 of 2 that time. And it's the Storm with the ball. Here's Canada. And she takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Rare assist from Howard. Normally she's one that is asked to end plays, not start them, but she does have some passing skills.
Pass to Coffey. Outside, Diggins Smith. Here's Coffey. Let's go with a 3. The Mercury with another miss.
She's had an off game, but her team has been able to pick up the slack and get it done here today.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and we'll shoot 2 at the line. It's going to go on Brittany Griner.
2 shots.
Shoot 2.
Good. Both shots good from the stripe.
Well, after she didn't have a single free throw attempt in the first half, she's been much more active since halftime, drawing some fouls.
Out to the left wing. Here's Smith, faked in off the glass.
Shaky defense down low again. It's just been a mismatch in the paint.
I'm sure they didn't go into this one expecting to get battered like this inside.
Outside Lloyd. That's in for her fifth field goal of the game. Makes her 5 for 12 thus far.
Well, when you're 5'10", you better have a floater like Lloyd if you want to score inside. Takes the block out of the equation.
To Diggin Smith. Good for her eighth field goal. He's attempted a dozen shots.
A tenacious player like Diggin Smith doesn't shy away from getting scrappy down low.
Pass to Prince. He's off from three.
Even without that three ball dropping for her, the defense should have done way more on that last play.
Yeah, and then he's got to be better as a coach. You can't stand seeing her having that much space to get her shot off.
Seattle with the ball. Outside Lloyd. Yes, it's good.
Today we're seeing what Lloyd can do. Put the ball in the bucket over and over. Her diverse skill set, it allows her to rack up some points.
Here's Diggin Smith. She makes her ninth shot of the game, and she has missed only four.
Well, they've built this lead through plays exactly like that. She's easily been the most consistent performer.
No question about that. I mean, she's just hitting everything in sight.
Beyond the arc. And Epiphany Prince with the three.
Good job creating just enough space to let that one fly.
Now here's Diggin Smith. Tight defense on her. Pass to Vaughn. It's rebounded by Seattle.
Nice work there to contest the finish inside.
Yeah, they got the shot they wanted, but her defense laid waste to those plans.
Outside Lloyd. Langhorn. Three on the clock. Here's Tuck. The three-pointer off the mark.
They got lucky. They got lucky. And the defense has taken a big chance, leaving her open behind the arc. And I'm not sure I'm okay with that game plan.
The shot by Vaughn. No good. Now here is Lloyd. Defense is right there. Misses from close range. Vaughn.
Cunningham.
Outside, Diggin Smith. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and she'll shoot one more at the line. That one misses.
Outside of basketball, Diggin Smith also loves to bowl. She balances life on and off the court wonderfully.
Well defended, and she's not someone who handles that type of defensive pressure really well.
Pass to Griner. Freeland right side. Good on the baseline, Jay.
Awesome mechanics. Breland anticipates how to get her feet set and rise up without hesitation.
Here's Prince. Now here's Bird. To the middle. Oh, hammer! Wow, she'll go to the line.
Second personal foul. At the line. Number 13, taking two shots.
Shooting two.
And
and she can't get the first one.
And the second free throw, good.
Not as productive of a trip to the line as she'd have liked. They really need all their free throws to go down at this point.
Pass to Cunningham. Here's Walker Kimbrough. Can't hit that one. Some solid defense from Sue Bird. To the right side. That time, and she'll get two shots at the line.
You don't want to foul her. Bird almost automatic at the line.
Sue Bird.
Shoot two.
The first one falls.
What's incredible about Sue Bird, she's won every championship, and she's won each of them more than once. College, WNBA, internationally, Europe.
He's perfect from the line this time. Here's Walker Kimbrough. And they can just sit on the ball here.
Enjoy it. They've earned the win.
No doubt. And so it's Phoenix easily grabbing this one. Thank you.